back, the fullback role? Is that you're really two starty guys right now that you're counting on?
Right now we've got two guys going into the game. You know, they're going to have to be good. They're going to have to be good at a lot of things, and they're going to have to be in shape. And so that's, I think they are.
Does that make it difficult for you guys when you try and do a goal line kind of package? You know, the normal ones you see with a fullback and two or three tight ends. Does that make it hard for you guys and just makes you scheme around it more? I guess, how do you approach that?
It does. I mean, it's you know, you obviously are going to have to be prepared for the situation because it could come up. And so to me, sometimes it's harder, you know, to practice it than it is to when you get in the actual game. When you get in the actual game, you've got, you know, you've got enough guys to get in the goal line formation and do it. But when you practice, you got the ones are going, now twos are going, and, you know, now that guy's here, but he can't be there. So that's hard a little bit. But when you actually get to the football game, I mean, you've got enough to get in a goal line 23 situation and get it done.
With Justin still listed as number two on punt returns, I mean, what are the actual, given the circumstances and kind of how thin they are at wideout, I mean, what would you kind of put the chances out of him actually getting out there if Devron weren't able to return a punt?
Well, this is obviously a big game for us, and we'll put the best people out there. I mean, maybe Devron's tired. You know, we're not worried about putting Justin out. Justin is one of our punt returners, so we don't look at punt return any different than third and eight with the game on the line. It's a big play, so we'll put the best people out there. So I've got all the confidence in the world in Justin Hunter being out there.
Everyone would say, with a guy coming back from any kind of knee injury or an ankle injury even, that, you know, maybe some apprehension on getting into the play and getting into, you know, kind of back in the flow of things. Is that different or the same on returning a punt, you know, if that were to actually occur? Do you think there'd be any holding him back or any nerves?
No holding back. I mean, I think it's the same as, you know, whatever he has the ability to do on offense, we think he has the ability to do there. And we've seen nothing on offense that makes us believe that Justin Hunter isn't 100%. I mean, he's ready to go. So that's the way we feel about him back there in any phase that we need him, to be honest.
Is Patterson going to be one of your kickoff return guys?
Patterson's one of our kickoff return guys, yes.
Is there any concern about that with Derek Rogers' injury with the depth of receiver? Or does that apply the same for Hunter's?
It does. You know, it's they're not bad questions, guys. They're good questions, but you just ask about two explosive guys, right? And I don't know, how many times does a receiver catch a ball on average in a game? How many times? I really don't know the answer to that question. But if I told you that either one of those two had seven or eight catches coming off of Friday night, you'd say, okay, well, we can almost guarantee that ball will end up in their hands on this play. So you see why we look at it the way we do. We want those guys to have their hands on the football. And, you know, whether we're talking about CP or Justin or Devron, that's a touch. It's a touch that we feel really good about.
Who else do you like as a kick return guy?
Devron is good, CP is good, and there's a host behind them. But, you know, right now we like both of those two probably as much as anybody.
Can Quinchon potentially help you there? Is he sure?
Yeah. We've seen some guys behind. You know, it's a couple, two or three good guys in front of them. So, you know, but we're right now obviously ready for anything to happen. You know, because a lot of times it has in this camp.
With some of the guys you brought over from defense, help out at tight end, fullback, I mean, who do you feel comfortable playing on Friday night?
Well, I was just talking about, I mean, you know, Greg King and Justin King have come over, and they're different guys. I mean, Justin is young, and a lot of things that he's got to get used to right now. It's a lot that are new for him. Greg has been through this before. But even with Greg, I mean, it's a lot to ask of someone to come over in a week. And we've put the pressure to him, and, you know, it's been a big deal where I've demanded a lot of him. Most of the time he's responded, sometimes he hasn't. And it's I've got to get him ready to play. I mean, it's my job, and it's Greg's job to get ready to play. That's just what it is.
Charlie, I apologize if you've already been asked, but what have Dar and Pilardi both shown in camp punting the ball that you guys will plan to use both on Friday night?
Well, it's extremely competitive the whole way through. And so, you know, they bring different things to the table a little bit. Obviously, with which leg they kick and start with. But, you know, you sit there and you look at Mike and he's got dual responsibilities and that comes into its own. And, you know, Matt's growing up. What you do, it's a body of work. You know, and I've been saying this all through spring because, you know, as a coach, you learn. You know, you learn. If you speak too soon and speak too often, you're probably going to end up taking back what you said. So what we try to do is go back to everything, all the times, even when they're in the look team, off to the side on their own. And what we came up with, what we thought was the best solution for game one. For game one, I mean, it's always a body of work. We'll be sitting here talking about maybe entirely different things in November. I mean, and the more you coach, the more you learn that. So right now, this is our time to attack.
Statistically speaking, Pilardi's body of work on field goals this fall camp has been his best. Has he been, from a scrimmage standpoint, has he been that good, day in, day out for the most part?
Yeah, I've been proud of Mike, the way he's approached it. It's a maturity thing. Not that he was immature early, but he was young. So, there's something to be said for getting out there and doing it. And I think he's worked hard in the offseason, hard this summer. It's so comparable to golfing that it's silly. I mean, really, sit there. I'm assuming you all play golf. If you don't, you're smarter guys. Maybe I'm giving you credit for it.
Fine, play golf.
Right, exactly.
Swing a club.
You know how it is. You go out there and it's just consistency. You change one thing with your golf swing, and now you got four things that you can't figure it out. And that's what it is as a kicker. So, they got to go there every day and be consistent, and have film study. Look at, here it is. Guys, this much right here, your geometry tells you this much right here with your step equals this much, up there next to the upright with the ball. We've all seen that for our golf swings.
Coach, as far as Pilardi on kickoffs, can he consistently get it into or deep into the end zone?
We think so. We think, it's another thing Mike's really gotten. I'll go back to golf again. What happens to you guys when you get out there to your golf swing and you say, I'm just going to tee off on this one? Usually ends up left or right or divot or something really bad. It's a lot of the same things here. Slow down. You don't have to kill it. When you do those things, you look up and now you get the ball 5 yards deep in the end zone.
As you look at what's reasonable to expect, and I know at both the tight end spot and at the special teams, you've had some injuries and things throughout the past summer and camp. But what's reasonable to expect is the growth and what you want.
I drifted on
you. No, it's fine. You've had some injuries and some guys have been in both positions that you're coaching.
Right.
There's been some depth problems and some club things there, but with what's reasonable to expect, have you been pleased with the growth overall since?
I look at the top to the bottom. Start with Mike and Bart going into it, and Mike was hurt. Mike has come back and done a good job, and I just look at it like this, and I said it when Downs got hurt, and love Brendan Downs and wish he was out here, but he's not. So once Brendan Downs gets hurt, number one is Brendan Downs. Feel bad for Brendan Downs. Brendan Downs, now you've got to get well. You've got to get well for yourself. You've got to get well to get back in here for us. Second person is, all right, trainer, that's what you do. Doctor, that's what you do. I'm not a trainer or a doctor. I can't help Brendan Downs right now other than he still sits in our meetings and he stays with us mentally. Now, what's my job, all right? My job is I coach the tight ends. So, will I have some recommendations? Hey, that guy over there doesn't look like he's getting used as much. So now, that's kind of where we were with King. And so right now I'm just coaching the heck out of King, trying to get him ready. And sometimes it can turn out to be a silver lining if, a month from now Brendan Downs is back and now you've got Greg King helping you too. All of a sudden you look up and you got four pretty good guys. And so it's a long season, guys. It's a long season. If you're going to have these kind of things happen, maybe it's better that it happens now.
Coach, on your kickoff returns, if you told your players, if they catch it 2 yards deep or 5 yards deep, if you told them to take a knee for a touchback, or are y'all still?
We talk about it. We coach everything. That decision might be made one step or a couple steps ahead of me. Coach Dooley talks about that a lot. And we'll go in with a plan. It may be different indoors as it is with the wind blowing or according to their unit, but we definitely talk about it. And obviously with the ball being moved up, we discuss it. But Coach Dooley, just like he makes a lot of decisions, he'll make that decision whether we bring it out or not.
Could it depend on which player catches it in the end zone?
Could. That's about as specific as I can get on that one.
You were just talking about the dynamics of a kick itself. What do you know about, to a layman in terms of in the dome, on kickoffs or even – kicks. Is there an effect? Is there any effect? Do you get a little extra? Do you?
It's not very windy.
Well, clearly.
So
unless they really crank the AC.
Right, and I've heard of that before too. And I mean, this surface is good, better for some than others. But ideal conditions for a kicker, obviously, indoors. And so we take that into account. You don't, typically you have to go in and think about
know, what if the wind's in his face? What if the wind's at his back? What if you get, you know, coaching in Chicago and Buffalo for 9 years? I know that world. And so, you know, we won't have to worry about that.
And, just talking about the tight ends and with the, you were talking about the defensive guys coming over, but can you just tell us, in terms of Bartholomew being effective, you know, early in the season, which kind of where that's at?
I can't say enough about Bart right now. And you know, just from the standpoint of how, you know, he's really was probably more of a fullback. And now he's, you know, he's coming doing both, and he's so versatile. He's been a team leader. He, you know, when I'm up in Justin King's ear or other body parts, Bart is the guy that takes him over, puts his arm around him, and you know, explains to him. And Mike's been good about that too. So there's something to be said of having a room. And like I said, I want Brendan Downs back healthy in the worst way, but. It's a good room, and you can go in, and you've got two seniors in there because they get some coaching done for you.
You talk about King, and said you're trying to coach him up. Obviously, how raw is he? And I'm sure he does some things actually really well. King helping you out.
Which King?
Greg.
Greg?
Yeah.
Greg's a football player, and Greg's on a lot of special teams, and Greg, you know, does a good job of all that, and just playing a position that ends up over top of the tight end a lot helps him. But, you know, he's got to come in and learn a whole new language. He's got to come in and learn it in a short amount of time. And so that's been what's hard. If Greg King were with us in camp, or goodness gracious, I mean, like back during the spring, I mean, I don't think it would be a big deal. But right now, he's got a long way to go and a short time to get there. Now, I'll say it again, what I said earlier to these guys. The first game is not the end of the season. So, I mean, you're getting somebody ready, and maybe he's ready game two. Maybe he's ready game three. I'm not talking to Greg about game two or three right now. I'm talking to Greg like, hey, you know, one broken shoelace out there and your butt's out there. So that's kind of the way I'm approaching him.
If that situation happens, would you expect him to be in there and, you know, go 100%? Or do you have expectations for him if a situation like that were to happen?
I don't think they will let us play. Well, they'll let us play with 10, but it won't be very good. So, yeah, he better get out there. Yeah, we're going to have a football game Friday night. And I say that all the time to him, you know, and we've got different personnel groups we can get into. But if we want to, you know, we want to line up the two tight ends, if something happens to one of them, then Greg King, you know, he's going to be on the football field.
How much do you see your tight ends taking Derek's spot in offense, catching passes and stuff?
You know, that's a Jim Chaney question. You know, you go in every week and you've got how much 12, two tight end stuff, how much 11, you know, three wide out stuff do you use? And it's hard. You know, it's really hard when you're in gym situation like he is right now. You know, you have a, you know, a receiver to leave, and you have, you know, a tight end situation. So what you do is you step back and look at the full picture, the big picture, and try to come up with the best thing for your team that week. And it may change week to week.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.